It's good to be back with you this week, and looks like winter is kind of settling in as we approach Christmas. We're in our second week of Advent. And as we always begin, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with us, and with your spirit. And this Wednesday, we're celebrating, of course, St. Lucy, who is a very important saint in the church. How she was a wise young woman and decided she wanted to remain a virgin the rest of her life and serve our Lord, which she did. And we hear, here's a wise virgin from among the number of the prudent who went forth with lighted lamps to meet Christ. And that's kind of what we're invited to do now during our second week of Advent, isn't it? Especially as we always, when we start, we want to offer up our wrongdoings, knowing that God is always there to help us, even though we sometimes forget that. And so you were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy. And you came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy. And you're seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. So let's have our Advent song, and we'll light our second candle, along with, we'll start our, light our first candle, and then our second candle.
Come surely, Lord Jesus, as dawn follows night, our hearts long to greet you as roses the light. Salvation, draw near us, our vision engage. One candle is lit for the hope of the age. Come quickly, Shalom, teach us how to prepare for a gift that compels us with justice to care. Our spirits are restless till sin and war cease. One candle is lit for the reign of God's peace.
And that's so true, eh? We're praying for peace in the world, especially this time of the year, for peace in the Gaza Strip, and peace in the Ukraine, and peace in our own homes and our own hearts. And our readings today, reflect that. And we're never alone. And we hear that from the prophecy of Isaiah, and it's amazing how these the prophecies have come true. And we hear, to whom can you liken me as an equal, says the Holy One? Lift up your eyes on high and see who created these. And that's God, eh? That's the immense beauty of this world, that when you start thinking about all the little inner secrecies that all come together. And of course, Isaiah prophesies, the lineage back to Jacob, and that's through St. Joseph, who betrothed Mary and took her as his wife, even though she was pregnant. And we also hear how we grow faint sometimes and we lose our way. Yet we always know that the Lord is always there for us when we come back, and he renews our strength. They will soar on eagle's wings. They will run and not grow weary, walk and not grow faint. And it's sometimes really challenging to have to do that, especially this time of the year. And so our gospel reading today is from Matthew. And it's a critical part of the mystery of our Lord, because he says, come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, For I am meek and humble at heart, and you will find rest. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. And that's so true, eh? And we often grow weary, especially this time of the year when the days, the light, we don't have a lot of daylight. And it's part of once we have Christmas, then the days start to become longer. And that's because we belong and we're longing to belong to God and abide in God. And His Word assures us that we won't grow weary when we do His will. By no means is His will easy. God gives us strength as we bear the burdens we are given throughout our life, which is His yoke. The strength we need and the rest we need comes as we do His will. And of course, Jesus presented that way to the oppression of those who were carrying heavy burdens and were being weighed down. He replaces the sinful yoke with His yoke, you know, what He terms my burden. Jesus shares the yoke with us and even calls our burden His burden. And that's how we find rest. And we heard in our first Sunday of Advent how we had to be awake and be alert. And then last Sunday, the second Sunday of Advent, we heard how, from Isaiah, He comforts us. But we also heard that we need to repent and to be sorry and make amends for the offenses that we might have caused. And we also know that when we're connected to somebody, it might be a good friend, a family member, even though we're not always together, we're always still connected. And that's the same with Jesus. We're always connected with Him. And so we have a choice to make in bearing Jesus' yoke. We can regard it as a heavy cross, which we might want to say, well, that's a heavy burden. Or we might want to rephrase that and not maybe complain and grumble like the Israelites did when they were in the desert, but meet Jesus with our open hearts and our souls and our mind, knowing that He will take us in His, He will comfort us like the Good Shepherd does in His arms. So Father, may we always strive to enter into your rest and thus find your strength. He pardons all the iniquities. He heals all our ills. And of course, we can pray to St. Lucy to ask her to intercede as she wanted to give her life to our Lord. Her mother wanted otherwise. And by Lucy praying to God, helped her mother accept Lucy's devotion to the heart of Jesus. So as we continue this week, let us be mindful of the many, many blessings we do have. And as I mentioned earlier, we have so many. And hopefully you'll have your Christmas trees up and your decorations up. And we're so thankful for all the people that support us day after day. And we pray for them. We pray to the Lord. And let's go to a hymn, O Come All Ye Faithful.
O come, all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. O come, ye, O come, ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold Him, born the King of angels. Oh, come, let us adore Him. Oh, come, let us adore Him. Oh, come, let us adore Him. Christ the Lord. God on this happy morning, Jesus, to thee be all glory give. Word of the Father, now in flesh appear.
Blessings that we're having and come to have, and I'm sure many will be enjoying Christmas dinners soon. And so let us open our hearts and welcome our Lord, you know, as we say the prayer our Father gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may be always safe from all distress, especially during this time of the year, as we wait for the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior on Christmas Eve. And for the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. And now is an opportunity to share a sign of peace with each other, a handshake, a hug, a smile, and I extend peace to each and every one of you. And now, as we prepare to receive our Lord, the Lamb of God.
Yeah.
And as we prepare to receive our Lord spiritually, we hear, "Behold, the bridegroom is coming. Come out to meet Christ the Lord." And that's what we're preparing for during this Advent season, as we now say the prayer to receive our Lord spiritually. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things. I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. And maybe instead of our community prayer, we might say a prayer to Our Lady. It was her acceptance from the angel Gabriel that without her, our Lord would not have been born. So Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy own Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the end of our death. Amen. And now let's go to him and get in the Christmas spirit. O come, Emmanuel. Makes it an easy burden for us. Let us maybe just hear him, Hail Mary, gentle woman.
The fruit of your womb.
when we hear, "Behold, the bridegroom is coming. Come out to meet Christ the Lord." There is one thing I ask of the Lord, only this do I seek, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. And now, as we come to a conclusion of this week's service, let's be renewed by partaking of this divine gift, and that's receiving communion sacramentally. As we pray, O Lord our God, that by the example of the Blessed Virgin Mary, your mother, and Saint Lucy, bearing in our body and death of Jesus, may we strive to hold fast to you alone, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Lord be with everyone and with your spirit. And may the Lord continue to bless everyone and keep you safe, especially during this holiday season. And welcome into your heart the love of our Lord. And if you have heavy burdens, if you're carrying burdens, give them back to God, and He'll make your load very light. As we conclude with shining on a cold winter night. So we'll see everyone next week. God bless. Sure if it's playing, so I'm gonna shut that off and we'll play another quick hymn. Jesus Loves Me. Here we go. Safe, as I've mentioned, and we will see you next week, and only be a few sleeps away from Christmas. God bless.